Penguin Random House Audio presents Don't Bullshit Yourself. Crush the Excuses That Are Holding You Back by Jon Taffer. Read for you by R.C. Bray, with an introduction read by the author. This book is dedicated to my muse, my amazing wife Nicole, who always believed and never doubted, even when I did.
Introduction. I don't embrace excuses, I embrace solutions. I believe that every right implies a responsibility, every opportunity an obligation, every possession a duty. John D. Rockefeller, American oil magnate. The worst excuse I've made in my life haunts me to this day. When my mother died in July 2012, we were together and had no unresolved issues for many years. However, there was a five-year period when we didn't speak. What precipitated that silence was an argument about something so trivial that I can't even remember what it was. For 5 years, I made excuses about why I couldn't or wouldn't call her. Yvette Taffer was old school. She would stand on ceremony so that it was up to me, her son, to make the first move, and I didn't want to do it. I was stubborn, but really, I had no courage. I created meaningless excuses like, it's the principle of the thing, or I won't compromise my dignity. I was just bullshitting myself. What a waste of time, energy, resources, and love. We all have to stop bullshitting ourselves. Fortunately, I came to my senses, albeit 5 years too late. One day, my brother Lewis and I were talking about an upcoming family event that my mom would be attending. As we talked, something in me clicked. I finally realized what a jerk I had been all those years. Right then, I picked up the phone and called my mother, apologizing profusely and feeling like a fool for wasting years we could have spent together. Waiting those 5 years to make that call is one of my biggest regrets. The time we lose to excuses is devastating. No one loved me more than my mother did. The woman who gave birth to me, nurtured me, protected me, and fed and clothed me. No argument is worth abandoning that person. Listen to me. Excuses hurt. They leave wounds and can scar. They are your enemy. They steal the future and can destroy you. Not calling my mother wasted precious time. Time, as you will learn in this book, is the most powerful thing we have. When we do not use it correctly, as was the case with my mother, it can hurt us for years. I have witnessed the destruction excuses wreak every day. As a business professional, for more than 3 decades, I've been in a unique and privileged position to see firsthand what excuses do to people. Long before Bar Rescue became a television phenomenon, I was helping to fix broken businesses and owners. The root cause of all the problems I saw were excuses. I can walk into any unsuccessful business or talk to a person who has been unable to fulfill a single dream and see the results of a series of poor decisions that got them to a bad place. The stench of failure hangs in the air like stale cigar smoke. Talk to the people behind the failures, and you'll often find that they are overachievers at explaining disappointment away with what they think are logical reasons. They are masters of bullshitting themselves. I've heard every outlandish and hackneyed excuse in the book, from I have no time to check my company books, to I can't make my business in New Jersey a success because taxes are too high, or there's turmoil in the Middle East and Ukraine, so I just can't think about trying to succeed, to my cat died. Come on. Excuse makers seem to put more time into crafting the perfect justification for their actions or inactions than to working and succeeding. But let's be real. It's not just owners of struggling bars who make excuses. We all do, and it's time for us to stop. In the short term, an excuse seems like an easy fix. It's anything but. Psychologists call excuse making rationalization, a defense mechanism we use to justify bad behavior and poor decisions. While the excuses seem perfectly rational to the excuse maker, everyone else is rolling their eyes. Excuse making is just a form of lying. When you make an excuse, you're holding yourself back. Why would you do that? Don't Bullshit Yourself teaches you how to identify and face those lies head on and turn them into a positive action. Excuses are a common denominator of failure. In my experience, they fall into six major categories, which we will go through in this book together to bust each one. Fear, knowledge, time, circumstances, ego, and scarcity. I chose these six because they've come up repeatedly during my 30 years of working with failing businesses, failing owners, and failing people, and when facing my own excuses that had the potential to derail me. Each chapter centers on one of these types of excuses, revealing its facets and manifestations. You might notice some overlapping themes. That's because the emotions that underpin excuses, unhappiness, frustration, and discontent, cause the excuses to feed on each other. We're going to break that up. I'm here to help. I've seen the power of people confronting their own excuses and turning their businesses and lives around, including my own. From people who defied the odds, resisting the temptation to make excuses, to those who struggled with excuse making and were not able to resist the temptation, we'll explore their instructive and inspiring stories in the pages to come. So don't shy away. It's time to grab this book and identify your own excuse making bad habits, and then let's work together to change them with actionable steps. My goal with Don't Bullshit Yourself is for you to become accountable every single day for every decision you make and action you take. Your excuses are lies, illusions, delusions, traps, and mirages. They're all holes we dig and then jump right into. I reject excuses and embrace solutions. When I'm done with you, you will too. In college, I studied cultural anthropology and saw that behavior in primates isn't so different from our own. This anthropology background has helped me to understand people at their core, what motivates them and what doesn't. At the end of the day, we're all responding to stimuli just as our ancestors, the cavemen, did, and very similar to how animals in the jungles do when it comes to protecting their own territory. From my experience helping bars, restaurants, nightclubs, and hotels survive and thrive, I am a grassroots expert on human behavior. It's easy to change a business. It's hard to change people, yet it's not impossible. One way to do it is to learn how to see an excuse for what it is, a false premise. Identify the real issue underlying the excuse making and address it in a straightforward, unemotional way. You've seen me do it on TV. In fact, on Bar Rescue, when I deal with an excuse maker, the first thing I do is feel out his emotional hot buttons and points of pride. If I choose to attack his pride, this place is a mess. It sucks. Often he will stand up like a gorilla, pounding on his chest and say, "I'm better than this." Does that motivate him to change? I always hope it will, but unfortunately, in many situations, it doesn't. So I switch to fear. What happens when your business closes? What happens when you go broke? What happens when you're bankrupt? I try to scare the shit out of him. Sometimes if he has kids, I'll even mention them. Is this the way you want your children to live? Are you going to have the money to buy them food, let alone send them to college? I hope that triggers him to think, wow, maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I need to change things. One way or another, I have to get him to that state of mind. My third tactic, and the one I unfortunately use the most, is confrontation. When there's no choice, I go at him like a classic drill sergeant and break him down. I beat on him until the moment comes when he doubts himself. And in that second, his mind will open up and he'll say, "Wow, you might be right. I might be wrong." In that fleeting moment, when his brain opens a crack, I can walk right in. Then he is ready to take a hard look at the deception of his excuses and the fact that the only person he's fooling is himself. Most of the time, my clients have a light bulb moment at this point. Now, after this revelation, we can get to work on dismantling the lies within their excuses and then work on dismantling the excuses and the behavior. The minute they take responsibility, everything changes. Once they're in a humble position, they really can see the absurdity of the stories they tell. We're going to get there together. To do so means shifting your mindset, consciously doing uncomfortable things, taking a risk, confronting your lies, and asking for help. You must be willing to make the changes necessary to turn your life from excuse-filled to one in which you're going after what's really important and not letting anything stand in your way. Unless you embrace solutions and do the work necessary to cut through your own crap, you will never win at business or in life. This book gives you a chance to confront your own baloney and get back to winning. Excuses hold back the person who feels like she is drowning in her business or her job. It's an illusion. Delusions, dishonesties, and foolishness control excuse makers, even though in most cases they know better. They are genuinely scared. The fear isn't fake. That's why diagnosing failure is so easy. If I can turn that lie around and see it for what it is, you're actually not too busy.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.